Hi guys, welcome back to my podcast our YouTube channel. So today I'm going to be talking about what has happened to the music genre R&B. Even though I listen to American R&B slightly more, I'm going to try and make references to British R&B because I am from the UK. I'm also going to be talking about what I think about R&B music and artists today. Rhythm and blues, also known as R&B, is a popular music genre that originated in the African American community in the 1940s. Record companies used this term to describe recordings marketed mainly to African Americans during a time where rock/jazz-based music was rising in popularity. One of the reasons I love R&B music so much is because R&B lyrical themes often talked about the African American experience of pain and the quest for freedom and joy, as well as relationships, economics, and aspirations. British R&B is more or less a response to American R&B in the 1960s. It was brought over by African American servicemen stationed in Britain. Many bands, particularly in the developing London club scene, tried to emulate black R&B performers. Now, in the late 80s and the early 90s, hip-hop started to dominate and captured the attention of American youth. Artists like Tupac, the Notorious B.I.G., and the group N.W.A. made hip-hop popular during this time. Because rappers usually talked about the reality of being black and working class, the black working class was hip-hop's main fan base. However, other groups enjoyed listening to it as well. Many people accused hip-hop of promoting violence and degrading women. I mean, to me it depends. Some rappers did that, however, other rappers used hip-hop to give a political message. It was hard for R&B artists at the time to sell their music or even have their music heard because of the rise of hip-hop. However, some adopted a hip-hop image. When I was growing up, late 90s and early 2000s to me had the best R&B music. R&B music during that time gave us artists like Brandy, Mary J. Blige, Usher, Monica, Crave David. R&B also gave us groups like Boyz II Men, TLC, SWV and Mystique. R&B was the genre of music known for popularizing love and relationships. I remember coming across a meme that said, "If the love doesn't feel like 90s R&B, then I don't want it." I also came across another meme that showed a picture of iconic music videos during the early 2000s with the caption saying, "Back when R&B made you want to fall in love." And that's why people reference R&B songs when talking about love. When you're going through some sort of heartbreak, you will most likely listen to a Mary J. Blige song because she makes one of the best love songs of all time. My favorite song from Mary J. Blige is "Without You." Yeah, see, baby, we've been too strong for too long. I also think R&B music back then valued women a lot more than what they do now. Back then, men used to profess their love for women. Mandem actually used to sing outside in the rain. Nowadays, what, men call it simping, or, you know, it's moist for boys to show their love for women like that. Oh god, what happened? I do think R&B music has changed a bit. I mean, take the artist The Weeknd. I love The Weeknd, but some of his lyrics are a little bit raunchy and explicit. Do you like the way I flick my tongue or no? Oh no. You can ride my face until you're dripping cum. As time has moved on, music has become more explicit, especially hip-hop and rap music. Don't get me wrong, I do love hip-hop and rap music. It's just, if I want to listen to these songs out loud, I have to make sure that my mum and my sister are not in the house, you know? Nowadays, I feel like R&B music in the UK is not what it used to be before. R&B went from this to this. You know, don't get me wrong, I love Adele and, you know, I love Sam Smith's songs. They can both sing well. But can you name me a black British artist that is killing it in the R&B game right now? During the early 2000s, R&B music was, you know, fairly mixed. Black British artists were being noticed, but now, where are they? Where are they at? From about 2005 to 2013, R&B sales started to decline. However, in 2010, hip-hop started to take from the R&B sound. It started to incorporate traditional R&B in the genre, with rappers such as Drake, who has opened an entire new door for this. This sound has gained in popularity, and it has created great controversy for both hip-hop and R&B in how to identify it. Music, especially R&B, has definitely changed. I mean, of course, throughout time, things do change. However, now when you want to listen to music, you have to go on YouTube or Spotify. Whereas before, you had to go to the shop to buy a CD. Do you remember CDs? I feel like with the rise of hip hop, that has made people neglect R&B music. I mean, they still listen to R&B music. It's just not the same as before. I feel like the artists we listened to back then, like Usher, Aaliyah, and Neo, made R&B music what it was back then. Now it doesn't have the same soul or the same meaning it used to. Again, I do like the songs of today. I just think I'm going to stick to my late 90s and early 2000s R&B music. Thank you guys for listening. Don't forget to subscribe. Comment down below what's your favorite R&B song and if you want to see more videos like this. Bye!